Okay, so now it's not too hard to believe that 505 should be the minimum. Maybe we should get approximately an idea of what root 5 is. Root 5 is, well, it's less than 2.4. It's bigger than 2. Bigger than 2.2. So maybe around 2.3 something. And 2.3 times 500 will be 1,000 plus like 150. So it's like maybe 150 or 1,200. Okay. And how can you convince yourself this is the minimum? Your square. And your circle's diameter was only like, say, this big, right? Then anytime you have something like this big, you're not gonna be able to do it with one circle. And if you just have sort of a little strip this big, and you're not even gonna be able to do it with two circles if you're trying to do it along the width. You can only do it like this. Okay, but then if you had something like that, then you run into a lot of problems. So it seems kind of clear that this is going to be the shortest length. So I guess most of it will be trying to justify it in a very convincing way. Instead of trying to show to overlap the whole square, maybe we could try to just do like we had the diagonal down half of the square, the rectangle that was half of the square, and then we had another diagonal, say. And so this was the square. And these all have length 500 root 5. So let's suppose circles have diameter less than 500 root 5. Okay. So what do we have to do with one of the circles? Well, one of the circles cannot cover these two points at the same time. Okay. And but it can cover, it might be able to cover these two points at the same time. And what it certainly can't do is it can't just cover like a portion of this bar and leave this whole line, because if it leaves any of these two points, if it leaves two of these three points, sorry, if it leaves this point and this point uncovered, or if it leaves this point and this point uncovered, the other circle is not going to be able to cover them. We can assume the circle covers this point because one of the circles has to cover that point. And so if it covers this point, okay, it can't cover this point. So it has to cover that point. Let's call it A. So this is assuming without any loss of generality. Cover this B and this C. And you can't cover C because it's bigger than its diagonal. Okay. So therefore, it has to cover B, because if it doesn't cover B, the other circle has too much to do. So already you know that the circle has to be bigger than the diameter, already is bigger than 1,000. Okay, so it's somewhere between 1,000 and 1,200, or whatever 505 is. Now, okay, actually, well, we're not really just concerned with these 3 points. We can move, but it does show us that we don't really need to consider the whole square, we just really need to consider some important points. And so one of the things we could consider is so it has to cover these 2 points. I might as well just draw in the line in between them. That's 1,000. Okay, so it has to cover those two. And the question is, let's look at the other two corner points. So let's say this is. And then let's draw another point halfway between. So this is at the 500 mark. Okay. The question is, does this circle also cover these 2 points? And the answer is no, because if it covered these, either of those points, okay, it would have to cover. It would have to have diameter bigger than the line joining these 2 points. Right, the diameter is the biggest distance from any 2 points on that circle, or within the circle as well. So it cannot contain either of these points. So it has to miss these 2 points. Okay. But if it misses both of those points, the other circle has to contain these 4 points to make up for it, which is a contradiction, because now the same problem happens, because these 4 points contain an interval that's longer than the diameter of the circle. Okay, so that's really the end of the argument to that. So let's call these 2 points, let's call it M and N. So moreover, it cannot contain exceed 500 root 5. Okay. So now we're at a contradiction, because maybe we can call this point. We already no, we use that C, but you know, let me call this A prime and B prime. So now the second circle has to contain A prime, B prime. Oh, by the way, it doesn't contain A prime and B prime for even more serious, like a violation of this condition that M and N violated, because the big diagonal is even longer than, the diagonal of the rectangle. Yeah, so the other circle now has to contain A prime, B prime, M and N. In particular, A prime N, which exceeds 505. Okay, so that's how I thought about this problem. And yeah, it's a very, very strange way to conclude the test. Usually the investigation takes much longer, and the last questions are worth 5 marks. So I hope you found that useful.